Season 4 of Titans is expected to take the show in some exciting new ways, but there are still a few important mysteries that need to be answered before the HBO Max series can move forwards entirely. That's why we thought it was only fitting to mention some of the biggest unanswered questions Titans fans need answered in Season 4. Stay tuned for all the juicy insider details. Is Dick Grayson ready to lead the Titans? Throughout the first three seasons of Gotham, Dick Grayson, the show's original Robin, was continually proven to be a problematic leader in the eponymous Titans. Dick has trouble learning the same lesson over and over again, owing to his tangled relationship with Batman, aka Bruce Wayne, and the weaponization of his upbringing. Even after ostensibly moving on from Batman and wearing the Nightwing outfit, Dick struggles to learn the same lesson. He is always leaving the other Titans in the dark, and he's gone off on his own so many times that it's reasonable to wonder why he joined the team in the first place. Just when it appears that Dick has learned from his mistakes, he uses kryptonite dust to incapacitate Superboy, or Krypto, so that he may arrogantly run off to confront Scarecrow on his own, a foolish decision that culminates in him being shot, beaten, and killed. While the show's script has at times felt like a poor portrayal of its main character, the HBO Max series is definitely taking its time in building Grayson's journey to the top of the table. It's possible that dying and addressing his inner demons in the Lazarus Pit is just what he needs to become a successful leader. One of the first things Grayson does after coming back to life is tell Rachel and Gar to unite the Titans, enacting a plan to take down Scarecrow that not only enlists the entire team, but also reintroduces Red Hood, aka Jason Todd, into the mix, allowing the characters to begin the slow healing process they require following his betrayal earlier in the season. However, viewers have seen Dick appear to overcome his problems in the past just to revert to his old habits. Titans Season 4 must either fully establish Nightwing as the leader he is destined to be, or set him aside for the sake of the other heroes once and for all. Will Bruce Wayne be back as Titans Batman? Ian Glenn has done an amazing job giving one of the most adaptable heroes in comic book history a fresh start. While Bruce Wayne is simply a supporting character on Titans, he has served as a surrogate father figure for both Jason Todd and Dick Grayson, and it's evident that a relationship has left both protégés with a lot of baggage. The eventual rise of Red Hood, a masked Jason Todd who joins himself with Scarecrow after being beaten to death by the Joker, is a major plot point in Titans Season 3. Bruce cracks and eventually breaches his all-important rule, brutally executing the Joker for revenge, unaware that the Lazarus Pit was used to bring Jason back to life. For the rest of the season, Wayne is mostly absent, leaving Gotham in the hands of Dick and the Titans. During this period, Scarecrow is able to use his friendship with Red Hood to enter Wayne Manor and establish a personal base of operations in the mansion and the Batcave. The moody billionaire isn't seen again until Donna Troy saves Batman from contemplating suicide at the last minute. In the Titans Season 3 finale, Wayne eventually comes home, viewing the damage done to Gotham during his absence and mending fences with both former Robins. Mr. Wayne looks to have a new perspective, but it's unclear whether he will suit up again. Have Titans seen the last of Wonder Girl? In Season 1, Titans added a complete cast of Dick Grayson's original contemporaries, including Hawk, Dove, Wonder Girl, and Aqualad, through flashbacks, as a way to ground the character's past while providing a few much-needed adult role models to the younger generation of up-and-coming Titans. Season 3 continues to gradually phase out of the old guard, with Donna Troy remaining behind while the rest of the gang returns to San Francisco in the finale. Donna is on her way to Europe to see Dove because she has a message from Hawk to deliver from beyond the dead, but her character has a few options. Titans suggests Donna teaming up with Argus at some point, which might lead to a standalone series for that character, but whatever her destiny holds, Wonder Girl is likely to remain a recurring guest on the show in the future. What exactly is the Oracle, and can Barbara Gordon find it? Barbara Gordon's third season on Titans was a frenzy. In quite a small period of time, the GCPD commissioner must cope with multiple high-profile murders, Batman's disappearance, the rise of Red Hood, Scarecrow's takeover of the city, and rampant corruption within the GCPD, which leads to her arrest. Most of these issues are handled by the end of the season, when Barb and V retake GCPD headquarters, and the Titans put a stop to Scarecrow's plot. With the Titans apparently heading to San Francisco for Season 4, fans may not see much of Barbara in the future, but the program did make a point in the finale to tease her continued work with Argus and her search for the dominant Oracle. This isn't the first time Titans has mentioned its own version of Oracle, which is still mostly a mystery within the Titan universe, so it'll be interesting to see how that plays out in the future. What exactly is the future of Argus in the Titanverse? The shadowy superhuman branch of the United States government, Argus, made an appearance in the Titans season 3 finale with V revealing herself as an active member all along. The organization moved into Gotham City after receiving information that Ra's al Ghul had returned to the city to create a Lazarus Pit as part of a larger, as yet undisclosed, scheme. Surprisingly, Roy Harper, Green Arrow's protege, who eventually became a full-fledged member of the Justice League as Red Arrow, was mentioned as a member of Argus, with V making sure to tell Barbara Gordon that he sends his compliments. Although it's absolutely conceivable, HBO Max is preparing a spin-off series centered on the organization, maybe similar to Marvel's Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. Let's hope this is a thread that Titans continues in season 4 and beyond. Highlights from the season 3 finale explain. Tim Drake will be a superhero, and many speculate it could be Robin. In Titans season 3, no one has taken Tim Drake's superhero ambitions seriously. Whether it's due to a lack of gym time or his superfan enthusiasm, with Donna Troy, Dick Grayson, and the Drake family all treating Jay Lacergo's role with kid gloves. In the Titans 3 season finale, Tim ultimately disproves his skeptics by landing a magnificent flying kick on a corrupt GCPD cop, causing Wonder Girl to raise an admiring eyebrow. Even Mr. and Mrs. Drake decided that their son is destined for vigilante greatness, and they let Donna, Gar, and Rachel leave with him. Tim's DC comic story is accelerated by their acceptance. Still, his father only changes his mind after Drake becomes Batman's third official sidekick. Tim Drake accepts Dick Grayson's offer of proper instruction at the end of Titans season 3, signaling yet another departure from the source material. Tim will work with Dick Grayson's Nightwing instead of Bruce Wayne's Batman to learn the ropes, which means he may not become Robin 3. The Robin mantle isn't really Dick's to pass on, and why would he want to after such a tangled past on Batman's side? Tim's eyes are firmly fixed on the green tights, but Titans are drastically altering Drake's path to becoming a superhero by continuing his story in San Francisco rather than Gotham City. Argus has been in the city this whole time. The third season of Titans introduced Karen Robinson as V, Barbara Gordon's tough guy GCPD aide, and a steadfast friend throughout Scarecrow's control of Gotham. V may be a no-nonsense secretary, but the Titans season 3 finale shows she isn't on the GCPD payroll, contrary to what the public and Barbara herself imagine. V works for Argus and has impressive hand-to-hand combat skills, as shown by the trio of knocked-out cops who had the misfortune of sharing an elevator with her. Argus, Advanced Research Group Uniting Superhumans, is DC's S.H.I.E.L.D. in DC Comics, and it is led by director Amanda Waller. The group has appeared in multiple DCEU films, and it usually assists superpowered good folks in defeating bad guys while keeping an eye on any potential threats. Roy Harper, often known as Green Arrow's sidekick Speedy, is one of Argus's leading figures in Titans. Although V does not reveal what job Harper holds at Argus, and DC does not explain Speedy's career move, the Archer is clearly familiar with Dick Grayson and Barbara Gordon. Argus has been operating in Gotham's shadows for some time, according to Karen Robinson's persona. After Ra's al Ghul arrived in Gotham, V was tasked with monitoring super activity, and previous references to the villain in Titans suggest this occurred some years before the show's storyline. And there you have it, everything you need to know about Titans Season 4, and some questions fans desperately needed answered. Additionally, we also mentioned a few highlights from the Season 3 finale. Make sure to let us know your thoughts down below. Did you watch Season 3 of Titans? What do you think will go down in Season 4? Let us know. But if you enjoyed today's video, don't forget to like and subscribe so you never miss out on any of our new and upcoming content. Thanks for watching.